Here I'm asked to solve a quadratic inequality. First thing I'm going to do is factor it. Factoring out a negative 1 here, I'll be left with x squared minus 2x minus 3. Then factoring the resulting trinomial will be a little easier here. X squared breaks up as x times x. We can factor 3 as 3 times 1. 1 and 3 add up to negative 2 if the 3 is negative. And then a 1 times a negative 3 is negative 3, so it's factored correctly. Now we want to determine our critical values. The critical values for a quadratic inequality are the zeros. So what we can do is set this equal to 0, and I think easily we can see x is equal to negative 1 will make that quadratic 0, and also x is equal to 3 will make that 0. So here we get two critical values. Now let's make a sign chart. The sign chart is going to tell us what x values will produce positive or negative results. Okay, so it's just a number line, 1, 2, 3, 4. You can also think of it as the x-axis of the graph. Here I'm going to use closed dots. Notice we had greater than or equal to. The equal to tells us it's inclusive, so I'm going to use closed dots, and that breaks the interval up, the number line up, into three regions: the right, the middle, and the left. At this point, you want to choose some test values to see if the result is positive or negative. So let's say we plug in 5. If we plug in 5, we'll have a negative, that's the negative 1. 5 will get a 6 there, that's positive. And when I plug in 5 here, I'll get 5 minus 3, which is 2, which is also positive. So I'll have three factors, one of which is negative. A negative times a positive is negative. So no matter what number you choose in that interval, you'll get a negative result. Let's choose a value in the middle interval. It looks like 0 would be the easiest. You could see easily on the first inequality here, if I plug in zeros for x, I'll be left with 3, which is positive. But let's look at that last one. I have a negative 1 or a negative. If I plug in 0, I'll have a positive there. And if I plug in 0 for this factor, 0 minus 3 is negative. I'm not really concerned about what the actual number is. I'm just concerned if it's positive or negative. A negative times positive times a negative is positive. So in that interval, no matter what number you choose, the result will be positive. Let's choose a test value in the left interval here. Let's say negative 5. Okay, so again, I'm having a factor of negative 1. Plug in negative 5 there. Negative 5 plus 1 is negative. And if I plug in negative 5 here, negative 5 minus 3 is negative. So when you multiply a negative times a negative times a negative, you'll be left with a negative. Okay, so you could see if I were to graph this quadratic, it would be a parabola that opens down. So a rough sketch would look something like this. See how it's positive where the graph is above the x-axis? So let's answer the question. Now we're going to use this sign chart. The question is, when is this quadratic expression, for what values of x can I plug in there that's greater than or equal to 0? In other words, positive. Well, we're looking at our sign chart. When is it positive? Whenever x is in this interval here, we will get positive results. Okay, so this is the answer expressed on a number line. But often we'll be asked to write that in interval notation, so we have to translate that to interval notation. We're going to use square brackets because we had the equal, remember, that was the closed dot, square bracket, from negative 1 to 3, square bracket like that. So that's the answer in interval notation. Infinitely many solutions, including negative 1 and 3.